A well-documented case of a local priest accused of sexually assaulting children in the 1950s through the 70s at a school for the deaf is now getting international attention.
The Vatican is responding to accusations it covered up the case. We have team coverage tonight. We begin with 12 News reporter Nick Bohr live at the Archdiocese headquarters.
And Terry, the irony here is that this facility is called the Archbishop Cousins Center after Archbishop William Cousins. And according to the documents obtained by lawyers for victims suing the church, it was Archbishop Cousins who moved Father Murphy to northern Wisconsin after learning of allegations he'd sexually abused children. The allegations against Father Lawrence Murphy have been reported before, that he abused some 200 deaf boys at the former St. John's School for the Deaf in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. But newly released documents shed light on the Vatican's role in efforts to expel Murphy from the priesthood. When the allegations surfaced in 1973, he was sent to northern Wisconsin, where he served as a fill-in priest. More than 20 years later, as past victims prepared to sue the archdiocese, Archbishop Rembert Weakland wrote to then-Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger, the current pope, seeking to expel Murphy from the priesthood, writing, quote, "My concern now is not simply for necessary justice. I am even more interested in a healing response from the church to the deaf community within the archdiocese so that their anger may be diffused and their trust in ecclesiastical ministers be restored." There's no evidence that Ratzinger himself responded to Weakland. In another letter, Murphy wrote to Ratzinger personally, asking he be spared from removal from the priesthood, saying he'd repented and was in poor health. The Vatican never gave the go-ahead, and Murphy died 10 months later, still a priest. The documents also include a letter from Archbishop Weakland to one of Murphy's victims, written shortly after Murphy died in 1998. Weakland writes that he was trying to get Murphy removed from the priesthood, writing, quote, "We spoke very strongly and at great length about it with Vatican officials. His recent death, however, put an end to this case." Milwaukee victim advocate Peter Isley is in Rome today calling for answers from the Pope himself.
We're Catholics from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and survivors. We need to hear from him why he did what he did with the man who raped and molested children in our archdiocese. We need to know why he did not let us know about him, why he didn't let the police know about him, why he did not condemn him, why he did not take his collar away from him.
Well, the Vatican took the extraordinary step today of actually responding to the news stories. We'll have that part of our coverage on 12 News at 6. Reporting live at the Cousins Center, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
Thank you, Nick. 12 News tried to reach Archbishop Rembert Weakland for comment today. He has not responded to our requests. The Archdiocese of Milwaukee released this statement. Murphy's actions were criminal, and we sincerely apologize to those who have been harmed. The Archdiocese of Milwaukee continues to reach out to victims, survivors who were harmed by Lawrence Murphy, and encourages them to report any abuse they suffered.